Big Broadway musicals, original review shows, comedic romps, and inspiring dramas. Servant Stage Company is the destination for exceptional theatrical experiences, both big and small. Serving Lancaster County and beyond by making great performances easily accessible to everyone, Servant Stage Company has the best of the classics, uplifting family-friendly productions, and a whole lot more. Servant Stage Company, serving our community, serving you.
Hello, friends, and welcome to the second week of our Living Room Concert Series. We were just thrilled with the response we received from last week's concert, and we're so excited to share with you even more wonderful music right here tonight. This is such a strange and difficult season for all of us, and we want to continue to do everything we can to uphold our mission in bringing the joy of great performance right to you wherever you are. Now, as a reminder, immediately following tonight's concert will be our second annual Servant Stage Family Meeting. We will be sharing the latest news and updates, as well as answering many of your questions. So stay tuned right after the concert. And a reminder that we have more Living Room concerts coming your way in the coming weeks, all taking place on Friday evenings and each one starting at 7 p.m. So make sure you come back each week to see and hear different performers and different wonderful music. We miss seeing your faces, but we love hearing from you. So feel free to use the comment section to let us know that you're here and that you're listening. And if you're watching on Facebook, you can like, you can love, you can send a comment in real time to the performers to let them know how much you appreciate their work and enjoy their talents. But for now, I think it's time to get on with the show. We're so happy that you're here tonight and so thankful for the many Servant Stage performers who have shared their gifts and their talents to make tonight possible. Jackie Zlacheski is going to kick things off for us and introduce our first song. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show!
Hi everyone! Thank you so much for joining Servant Stage's virtual concert. My name is Jackie, and on behalf of Servant Stage, we're so happy you're joining us. The song we're about to sing is called Somewhere from a classic musical called West Side Story. The song is sung by a beautiful character in the show called Maria, where she hopes and dreams for a better world. I think on behalf of Servant Stage, we would like to sing the song in honor of you. Somewhere, somehow, someday, we're all gonna be back together again, whether if it's at our outdoor venues or at another one of our concert halls that we use to put on one of our great shows. We all love you so much, and we hope this blesses you today.
There's a place for us.
Hold my hand and I'll take thank you all so much for that beautiful song and message. Thanks to all of you for joining us. While it certainly was not unexpected given the current circumstances, we were heartbroken to have to announce the postponement of our production of Amazing Grace. We are grateful that we have received permission and the rights to bring the show back and have Amazing Grace as part of our 2021 season. So we do look forward to that. But in the meantime, we wanted to share a little bit of this beautiful show with you right now, tonight.
Hi everybody, Christopher G. Smith here from Amazing Grace on Broadway. This next song, out of all the songs in Amazing Grace, this one was written first. And the reason for that is it wasn't written for the show at all. I wrote it 30 years before Amazing Grace premiered on Broadway. I was 16 years old. This is the second song I ever wrote in my life. And it was after a sunrise Easter service. And there was something about the darkness fading and the light and the birds and all of the sounds and just life coming back after a dark time. And I wrote it for the people in my youth group. It was just a labor of love. It's just something to encourage them. And I put it on a mixtape and I gave it to my best friend and she hung on to it. And later on, we fell in love, we got married, we had kids, and then the idea for Amazing Grace. And she kept saying, you have to find a place for Daybreak. You have to put Daybreak in Amazing Grace. And you know, I'm like, well, it doesn't really work that. I get the musical theater 101 response. You know, you write the songs for the show, not the show for the songs. So needless to say, this is an act two of Amazing Grace, where it really was something that just blessed a lot of people. So let's listen to Ashley Hayward singing Daybreak from Amazing Grace.
When daybreak is only a heartbeat away, with barely a moment till dawn, the mist-covered trees are shrouded in gray as the earth introduces its song, as the birds start to sing a hymn, praising darkness yielding to light, and a new creatures that fear the light, and they hide in their burrows and wait for night. But you are not one of them, no, you are a child of the light. So shaken our faith, fade away.
Hey everybody, this is Nick Olson. I hope you're all well and that you've been enjoying the Living Room Concert Series as much as I have. I'm really thrilled today to be joined by two extremely talented gentlemen singing probably the most well-known song from the 1996 Disney classic, The Hunchback of Notre Dame. This song takes place around the beginning of the story, and the main character, Quasimodo, who's been secluded his whole life, talks about his yearning and deep desire to be with people and a part of the outside world, which we can all probably relate to nowadays. This is Out There, and I hope you all enjoy.
Safe behind these windows and these parapets of stone, gazing at the people down below me.
All my life I watch them as I hide up here alone, hungry for the histories they show me.
All my life I memorize their faces, knowing them as they will never know me.
All my life I wonder how it feels to pass a day not above them, but part of them.
And out there, living in the sun, give me one day out there. All I ask is one to hold forever.
Out there, where they all live unaware, I'd give
what I dare just to live one day out there.
Out there among the millers and the weavers and their wives, through the roofs and gables I can see them.
Every day they shout and scold and go about their lives, heedless of the gift it is to be them.
If I were in their skin,
I'd cherish
every instant out there, strolling by the sand.
Taste the morning out there like ordinary.
Freely walk about there just one day, and then I swear I'll be content
with my share.
Won't resent, won't despair.
Old and bent, I won't care.
I'll have spent one day.
Thank you, gentlemen, for that absolutely stunning performance. We are so thrilled to continue to offer all of these virtual concerts as Pay What You Will, keeping in line with the mission at Servant Stage to making entertainment accessible to everyone in our community. So thank you so much to those of you who have already given during this difficult time. If you'd like to donate today, you can do so using the donate link on this page or by visiting servantstage.org/donate, or by simply sending a gift in the mail. We are a 501c3 nonprofit, which means all donations are tax deductible. Now, coming up next, we have a beautiful song of joy performed by Cat Prickett and Rick Zimmerman, and accompanied by Scott Rollins.
I pray you'll be our eyes and watch us where we go and help us to be wise in times when we don't know. Let this be our prayer. To a place, guide. with your grace. Give us faith so we'll be saved.
I pray we'll find your light.
I pray for your light.
And hold it in our hearts.
And hold it in our hearts.
When stars go out each night. So we'll be safe. A world where pain and sorrow will be ended, and every heart that's broken will be mended, and we'll remember we are all God's children, reaching out to touch. To the sky, we ask that life be kind.
We ask that life be kind.
And watch us from above.
And watch us from above.
We hope each soul will find.
We hope each soul will find
another soul.
Comments about Emily Aziza's harp playing and the beautiful instrumental from the first concert. So we are so happy to have Emily returning again in this concert, and we hope you enjoy her beautiful arrangement of Memory by Andrew Lloyd Webber.
Thank you. Servant Stage family. My name is Dylan Jacob Laura. I am so happy to be doing this song with many of my friends virtually. I hope everybody who is listening is staying healthy. And this is my favorite things from Sound of Music.
So, what are your favorite things that you like to think about? Mine are animals, family, theater, and most importantly, Jesus.
Although I have eaten crisp apple strudel and I have a white dress, some of my favorite things are lollipops and my cat Pixie. But during these difficult times, it's especially important to focus our mind on things that are true, right, noble, and pure.
Some of my favorite things are being on stage, being with my family, being with my friends, and God.
And one of my favorite things to do is to sing with Servant Stage Company.
So with the help of this song today, I hope that you can set your minds on your favorite things and the things that make you smile.
Raindrops on roses and whiskers on kittens. Bright copper kettles and warm woolen mittens.
Brown paper packages tied up with strings.
These are a few of my favorite things.
Cream-colored ponies and crisp apple strudels.
Doorbells and sleigh bells
and schnitzel with noodles.
Wild geese that fly with the moon on their wings.
These are a few of my favorite things.
Girls in white dresses with blue satin sashes.
Snowflakes that stay on my nose and eyelashes.
Silver white winters that melt into springs.
These are a few of my favorite things.
When the dog bites,
when the bee stings,
when I'm feeling sad,
I simply remember my favorite things, and then I don't feel so bad.
Hello again, friends. This next song that we are so excited to share with you is a mashup of two of my favorite songs growing up that just exude so much joy and life and hope. So here is a mashup between Precious Lord and Closer Walk. Enjoy.
Just a closer walk with thee.
Daily walk
but thou art strong.
Just a closer walk with thee.
Jesus, keep me from all.
Just a closer walk with thee.
I'll be satisfied as long as I walk. Let me walk close to thee. Just a closer walk with thee.
Just a closer walk with thee.
Granted, Jesus is my
plea. Just a closer walk with thee.
Daily walking close to thee. Is
over.
And time for me will be no
just a closer walk with thee.
Guide me gently, safely on to thy shore, kingdom shore, to thy shore. Yeah, yeah, just a closer walk with thee. Granted, Jesus, tis my plea.
Just a closer walk with thee.
Ooh, daily walking close to thee. Let it be, dear Lord, let it be. Let it be, dear Lord, let it be. Dear Lord, let it be. Dear Lord,
Kayla, Jeff, and Joe. It's our joy to share this music with you, and we hope you've enjoyed it. We'd love for you to stick around to after tonight's concert for our Servant Stage family meeting if you're interested in learning more about our theater company. But now, to close out tonight's concert, we have one more song from the musical, Amazing Grace. Please welcome Sarah Zahn and Reggie Woods to introduce it.
One of the most beautiful experiences I have ever had in the theater happened at Amazing Grace on Broadway. So at the end of the show, the entire cast lines across the stage and they sing Amazing Grace. Now when that happened, the first strains of the music went and everyone started to stand around me. And there we stood, shoulder to shoulder, singing Amazing Grace. And I looked down the aisle, both sides, and saw that there were people just of every age, every race, every socioeconomic status that were in that room at that moment were all singing Amazing Grace. I even peered up into the balcony to see if they were singing too, and they were. It was one of the most profound and beautiful experiences I have ever had, and I will never forget it.
Hi, I'm Sarah. I'm so happy to be able to share this song with my Servant Stage family and give everyone a big virtual hug as we sing the song together. Thank you for being a part of the Servant Stage family, and feel free to sing along and enjoy this beautiful, hopeful song with us.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now am found, was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear.
first in me.
For being with us. Thank you for watching and joining us for this living room concert. Hope you enjoyed it. And we thank you so much for supporting Servant Stage as you were able during this difficult season. Coming up next, it's our Servant Stage family meeting. We would love to have you join us for that. No need to go anywhere. It'll be playing right here in just a minute. So stick around and thank you for being part of the Servant Stage family.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Servant Stage Company's family meeting for 2020. While we're unable to gather in person this year, we are so grateful for technology, allowing us to continue to give you the opportunity to hear more about Servant Stage's mission, have some of your questions answered, and also take a peek behind the curtain. My name is Nathan Claycomb, and I serve as Director of Development and Community Engagement at Servant Stage. I joined the team just over a year ago after seeing several performances and really having our family benefit from the model of pay what you will. It's our mission to make live theater accessible to everyone in our community, regardless of financial or physical limitations. Now, just before we begin the Q&A, I'd like you to meet the rest of the Servant Stage staff. Hello, friends. Let's start with Jonathan.
Thanks, Nathan. And thanks to all of you for joining us. My name is Jonathan Bauer, and I am the executive director of Servant Stage. My wife, Rebecca, and I started Servant Stage in 2011. So I've been in this position for 9 years now. And it has been such a joy to serve our community in this way, alongside such a wonderful team.
Hello, friends. My name is Wally Calderon. I just celebrated my 4th year as the artistic director of Servant Stage Company. Prior to coming on full-time, I had the pleasure of directing a handful of shows, including Yankee Doodle Dandy, Old Fashioned Christmas, and the Old Time Gospel Radio Hour. Thanks so much for being here.
Hi, my name is Tyler Hoover. I serve as managing director with Servant Stage Company. I was blessed to come on staff just over 3 years ago. Prior to that, I served as a music director for several of our summer camp productions, as well as a cast member, with my first experience with Servant Stage being as a cast member in Forever Plaid back in 2015.
Hi, everybody. My name is Lauren Groff. I serve as touring manager for Servant Stage. This past March marked my 1 year anniversary working on staff. And before that, I had been involved with Servant Stage as a volunteer, as a summer camp assistant with Godspell Jr., and also as a performer in Titanic and A Christmas Carol.
It's so great to see all of you tonight. It's like the gang's all back together. Now, some of you may recognize our faces, but did you know there are two other team members who joined us in 2019? First, I'd like to introduce you to Brianna.
Yes, well, hello, everyone. My name is Brianna Van Vliet, and I am the audience services manager for Servant Stage. I started with Servant Stage back in September of 2019 as the audience services manager, but before that, I had the privilege of performing in Civil War and Old Time Gospel Radio Christmas. And then a couple of years later, I came back and I had the opportunity to be a camp counselor for all three of the camps during the 2019 season. I think what drew me to Servant Stage is in the name. The fact that they are so community driven about serving the community and taking the opportunity to create theater for people who are less fortunate means the world to me because that's what I'm here to do. I'm here to serve people who, you know, don't always have the best opportunities to serve themselves. That's not something that's heard of within theater. My family, for instance, would have to pay hundreds of dollars to take a family of five to see a show at the theater. But with Servant Stage, families of 10 can come see the show for free and pay what they're able to. And I think that's absolutely beautiful.
That is so true, Brianna. Thank you. And now I'd like to introduce you to a face that you may be familiar with from on the stage. Joining us behind the scenes as well is Rebecca.
Hi, everyone. My name is Rebecca, and I am the administrative assistant for Servant Stage. I joined the staff in January, but first got involved with Servant Stage as a performer in 2016. I loved my experience. I loved the mission. I thought it was so unique and so great. I knew I wanted to continue to be a part of the company. I was able to start assisting with the summer musical theater camps, and I've been able to stay involved in the youth program as a music director and assistant director. I am also so excited to be working with Teen Company, which is happening this year. It is so crazy to see how Servant Stage has grown and continues to grow over the last 4 years. One thing that really sticks out to me is the youth program. We started with 1 or 2 summer camps, and now we have 4 summer musical theater camps, a winter camp, Teen Company. We just keep expanding, keep growing, and have been able to see so many students get involved in theater. I'm so excited to continue to be a part of it and to see how it keeps growing. I wear a lot of different hats with Servant Stage, but I am very thankful to be involved and very thankful to be a part of the Servant Stage family.
Thank you, everyone. We also have two additional staff members working behind the scenes to make sure this mission continues. Dan Lenning is our database administrator, and Jim Bauer serves as our bookkeeping and records manager. Now let's get started with the Q&A tonight, welcoming back Executive Director Jonathan Bauer. Jonathan, this is a unique season, and many folks are wondering, how are we navigating this crisis? What does it mean to cancel shows, and what does this mean for the future of Servant Stage Company?
Sure. Well, right from the start, our top priority has been on the safety and the health of our audiences, our performers and production teams, volunteers, and our community. We miss you all so very much, and we are heartbroken over the cancellation of productions. We are facing the uncertainty and the financial hardships and loss of revenue. We know that many of you and family and friends are facing even more serious challenges at this point, and some of you battling for your lives or the lives of family members, and we want you to know that our thoughts and our prayers are with you. As the news changes every day, we are constantly evaluating and weighing different scenarios for the year ahead and looking for what the best way forward to return to live performances is. But I think that in many ways, the mission and the work of Servant Stage is just as important or even more important right now today than it was even a few months ago. The arts provide something that is truly needed right now more than ever. They provide the inspiration and the hope and joy and escape from the constant pressures of the day. And it's not just an escape, but the opportunity to step back and to look at things through a new perspective and to be encouraged, to be inspired and challenged right where you're at, and not just a distant hope for a future where things are going to be better. So in all honesty, we have been working harder than ever in this season to continue this work and to continue our mission and find new ways of making an impact and serving our community. And I'll let some of the rest of our team share some of those specifics, but that has truly been our focus right now. I know that many other theaters have been forced to make the difficult decisions to let their staff go or to furlough them indefinitely. But we are committed to continuing our mission during this difficult season. We're committed to you, our audiences, and we're committed to our staff. We are so grateful to you, to many of you that have been able to continue your support during this difficult time and to make it possible for us to keep serving, even with the loss of revenue from productions. So we thank you so much for making it possible for Servant Stage to continue serving the community. I also do think that the unique model of Servant Stage and where we're at gives us a lot of hope for the future and that we'll be able to bounce back quickly. We do have so much flexibility and adaptability where we're at right now. We're not paying hundreds of thousands on a mortgage or to keep up a building. Even with our tickets, we're not expecting people to pay $50, $60 for a ticket to come see our shows in a season of financial hardship and uncertainty. The reason Servant Stage is here is for those people that can't afford it. Our model has always been and will continue to be pay what you will. So we look forward to when we are able to gather again together safely. We look forward and expect our audience to just continue growing and to be able to continue making an impact in our community.
Thank you, Jonathan. You know, I'm asked frequently, are we still looking for a future permanent home? Can you provide us some updates on that?
Well, obviously, all of that is on hold right now, given the current circumstances. But I just want to say we are so grateful for the guidance and the wisdom of our board of directors during this season. And we're just thankful to be where we are at right now. The mission of Servant Stage has always been accessibility. And so the outreach performances into the community, whether it's retirement homes or schools or parks, that has been and always will be the heart of Servant Stage. We do think that as we continue to grow, we do still believe that a home base will become necessary and important for us to maximize our impact and to become even more accessible. But for right now, we are We're continuing to explore all of those options and searching for the best opportunity for a permanent home base. But we're continuing with our mission and whatever resources are available in the meantime. Just grateful for the opportunity to serve the community with whatever we have.
Absolutely. And thank you, Jonathan, and to our entire board of directors for your unparalleled leadership during these times. Now, when we're able to tour Lancaster County and beyond, there's someone at the head of that touring production, and that is Lauren Groff, our touring manager. Lauren, please share with us a little how the touring model has changed during this particular season.
Oh, absolutely. We hands down miss our touring shows. I miss the friends that we have at the retirement communities and nursing homes especially. To me, that's the heart and soul of what we do. So to put that on pause for a season is really difficult. But I'm also very thankful that Servant Stage is able to pursue our mission of making the arts accessible, even in quarantine, and even if we have to get a little creative. So to share with you a little bit of how we've been able to offer the Servant Stage experience to those retirement communities would be for the what would have been the show run of Don't Rock the Jukebox. Over those dates, we were able to drop off some DVDs of our past jukebox shows and some programs to hand out to residents, as well as making all of our retirement communities aware of Servant Stage at Home on our website to stream past performances, and also of this living room concert series as well. So they're all made aware that that's an option for residents, especially if they have the closed circuit TV system set up in their retirement community, which many of them do. So they're able to broadcast to individual rooms. Fun fact, that actually happens during our live performances many times too, where we are performing in the space and then that gets broadcast out to individual rooms and residents that maybe it's not a good time for them to come, or maybe they're physically not able to. So we're so happy that there are still opportunities to make the arts accessible to our community.
And we're certainly providing as many opportunities as possible. Lauren, what is the most rewarding thing about working with Servant Stage?
Wow, that's a great question. If I would boil it down to one word, it would be the people. And as cliche as that might sound, the what gets so affected by the who. So being able to interact with a cast, a crew, staff, and our community and volunteers, that makes all the difference because everybody has a part to play for sure. So for my role specifically, I would say the intergenerational aspect, being able to go into retirement communities and connect over music or share this experience of the arts is really meaningful to me. You see folks coming in to our performance space at a retirement home. Many of them might be in wheelchairs or hunched over or not able to function independently anymore or just having a bad day. And it's such a joy to see them blossom throughout the performance because they're recognizing the songs, they are starting to sing along, they're forgetting about whatever else was going on in their world that day, and we're all able to connect in this common experience of the arts. And that's just the show. So before and after the show too, being able to connect with all these folks as individuals, less as a general audience, is really special. All the time they tell us, you made my day. Well, I tell them back, you made my day. So the intergenerational aspect, of course, is such a huge rewarding part for me to be able to share that experience with them. And me seeing the show 30 or 40 times doesn't get old because I'm seeing it through the eyes of somebody who needs to see it. And that continues to feed my inspiration. It's so rewarding to be a part of.
Thank you so much, Lauren. We have experienced such tremendous growth over the past 9 years at Servant Stage, and we're tracking that growth, both in person at our performances and also online. Tyler Hoover has been doing a phenomenal job at interacting with our social media platforms and our website, and he's also taken a look at some of the numbers. Now, Tyler, can you provide us an update as to where we've been and even what we've seen so far in 2020?
Thanks, Nathan. Well, to really appreciate the growth and the engagement of our community, we've got to look back at some of the numbers from last year. So in 2019 alone, we had over 50,100 audience members over the course of 168 performances. This marked a 17% increase from 2018. And we saw similar leaps in our marketing reach. Our snail mail newsletter mailing list climbed over 8,200 addresses, which if you would like to be included on our newsletter mailing list and you're not, we would love to have you. Please sign up for that on our website, servantstage.org. On Facebook, which is always a huge means of marketing and promotion for us, our average monthly reach on Facebook climbed to over 60,000 last year, which was a 90% increase from the year prior. So thank you so much for liking and commenting and sharing our posts. We so appreciate that. Our website also saw an uptick with 14,740 average monthly web page views. So we rolled into 2020 continuing in our strategies for promotion on social media, and we're thrilled with the engagement we were getting there. We marketed for Frozen Junior, and we're thrilled to have over 2,500 audience members come out over the course of four performances. And then COVID hit, and we had to suddenly think about new and innovative ways to continue in our mission, continue to reach those in our community with these performances. And so that led to several new initiatives like our hand washing video series, which were so much fun. And if you have not checked those out yet, I encourage you to on our YouTube channel or on Facebook. We launched Servant Stage at Home, which was our way to stream past performances on our website. And so as of today, there are 10 performances available on Servant Stage at Home. And we're thrilled to announce that just in the last month since we launched that platform, we've had over 1,000 streams. And I just love seeing the feedback from folks who are getting to relive their favorite shows or getting to see productions for the first time they may have missed. And so we're so thrilled to have that available and encourage you to check that out if you haven't already. And that brings us to these living room concerts, which have been a joy for us to put together. We've had over 80 performers involved. We've been blown away by just the generosity of the community in pouring into these. Since we've been launching a lot of these new initiatives, marking around March 1st, we've had 250 new followers to our Facebook page since March 1st. That's more than a 200% increase from the 8 weeks prior to that. We've also had over 6,100 engagements. So that's likes, comments, and shares, which is nearly a 3,000% increase from the prior 8 weeks. Looking at just the first living room concert a week ago, we averaged about 325 viewers consistently over the course of that premiere on Facebook and YouTube. Now we're at 490 views on YouTube, over 1,400 engagements on Facebook, and an estimated reach of more than 10,000 people just in the last week from that first concert alone. So thank you so much for liking, sharing, commenting, telling your friends, continuing to spread the word about what's happening at Servant Stage. We are so encouraged and blessed to be a part of this community, and we thank you for being part of it with us.
Yeah, these virtual concert series have been so amazing. I've loved them. People all across the nation are enjoying them. Tyler, follow-up question for you. Could you tell us a little bit more about how the virtual concerts are being created?
Sure. This is a question that we've gotten from a number of folks wondering if we use Zoom or just how the editing on these concerts worked and how we put it all together. And it's been quite a process and a joy for us, but a lot of steps to it. And so this whole thing started with our staff compiling a list of songs that we knew from other shows, from past performances that we've done, and all songs that carried a message of hope and inspiration and just the message that we wanted to share with our community in this time. From there, we reached out to performers in the community who had either worked with us in the past or auditioned for us, asked if they wanted to be involved, and we were overwhelmed by the outpouring of generosity from just the amazing talent in this area, willing to give of their time and excited about the project. From there, we recorded conductor and/or pianist videos that then went to the performers. They would listen to the accompaniment and record their vocal tracks, send them back to us. We loaded that audio into an audio processing program where we would mix and EQ the audio, try to eliminate background noises and that sort of thing, to really bring the quality of the performances and the incredible talent to the forefront of what you hear and experience as the listener. Then once the audio was completed, we take that back and sync it up with all of the individual videos and place and arrange them on the screen. So a lot of contributing pieces to the process. Just in the concert tonight alone, there were 98 individual videos contributing to the finished product. And so it has been a joy for us to put it together. And again, we've been overwhelmed by not just the talent in this region, but the generous hearts attached to that talent who are willing to give of their time so generously to continue to reach into the community and inspire and be a blessing in that way.
And we certainly are enjoying these virtual concerts, but we also know that this season is very different than what we had hoped to perform for our audiences. As a team, we continue to want to come up with creative and new ways to make sure that the arts are accessible. Wally Calderon, as artistic director, is at the heart of this creative process. Wally, can you speak to the season so far and where we're headed from here?
Right. I think that this is definitely a very different season than we originally planned for. And I think that we have to recognize that this season, even with the differences and the changes, has already been a success. We started the year with Frozen Junior, which was just an amazing experience for both our performers and our audiences. We went through an amazing rehearsal process with Don't Rock the Jukebox, those amazing teens who ultimately didn't get to perform that show but had a wonderful process. We went through the planning stages and the casting of Amazing Grace. And so we were very excited about that that process, getting ready to start that. And we're excited to say that Amazing Grace is still going to be able to come back next season. So finding ways to do that. So we keep looking ahead. We keep looking for ways to continue our mission, to bring quality entertainment to the people that need it, to everybody. We've come up with a lot of social media and videos to keep people engaged. And of course, these living room concerts, it's finding our way to still get the mission out there, to still be able to produce these shows. And the living room concert has just been a fantastic process as well. We look forward to the summer, where we are going to hopefully pick up where we left off with our camps, with our summer show, Broadway Melody, and with our teen company. Again, just a sign that the growth of our youth theater program is just fantastic. And we're going to find ways to do each of these things. Again, we're watching every day, and we're discussing and assessing every single day of how to continue doing what we do best, which is just to serve the community, serve those around us, our performers, our cast, our crew, and to continue to make these products and these shows accessible to everybody. So we have plans in place for the summer and moving forward of how to keep doing that, whether it's online, whether it's in small audience, locations. We're going to bounce back from this, and we're looking forward to finishing the year just as strong as we started it. And looking ahead to next year, picking up again where we left off and to continue to grow and move forward.
Yes, we absolutely will. Wally, I am already being asked about the 2021 season. Folks want to know what's on the schedule, and specifically, will we be offering shows for even younger youth performers? What can you tell us about 2021?
Yes, the question everybody always wants to know, what is next season? Well, I can tell you, as I mentioned earlier, that we've already received the rights and the permission to produce Amazing Grace. So that will be right there, front and center in next season. We're excited to be able to still do that and to hopefully bring back a lot of the same people who were working on it this time around. So we're looking forward to that. We've definitely discussed and have narrowed down the list of shows that we're looking to do in 2021. you know we can't tell you that. I don't even know why you would ask the question. Of course, in October, we will be very happy to announce all of those things. And the question about our youth theater, doing shows for younger performers, absolutely, it's on our radar. And honestly, just as with Teen Company and the teen shows and our camps, they just keep growing. And the need and desire for those opportunities continues to grow. And honestly, we're just trying to keep up with it. We're trying to make sure we have the bandwidth to accomplish all of those things. So as those needs continue to grow, we will continue to grow and absolutely look forward to the future where we can offer new things, new opportunities, opportunities for younger performers, opportunities for young technicians. We've had a lot of requests for that. So our ears are always open. We're always listening to those questions. And we're always doing planning in advance, looking ahead to the future where we can find a path to those things. So stay tuned, stay with us. But we're excited already about the opportunities that we have this year with Teen Company, with the extra camp, and then things that we have in the works for next year as well. So our youth theater is a huge part of what we do and what we're excited about. So we're looking forward to the coming weeks, the coming months, the rest of this season, and next season as well.
Thank you, Wally. I completely agree. The future is a bright one, and we have so much to look forward to. Looking back, I joined the team just over a year ago in 2019, and I had no idea it was going to be such a record-breaking year, both in the amount of audience members that we saw, and also it was a record-giving year as well. So on behalf of the entire team at Servant Stage, thank you to those of you who stepped up and supported our mission of making live theater accessible to everyone. Without you, our live performances wouldn't be possible. Without you, our virtual concert series wouldn't be possible. Our Servant Stage at Home wouldn't be possible. In fact, I believe we're reaching more people now than ever before. I mean, think about it. Our performances are online, so we can reach people all across the globe with inspirational, uplifting, encouraging performances. If that's not accessibility, I don't know what is. Now, in 2019, I had the great pleasure of building relationships with many of you, whether it was on the phone, during performances, or in your home. 2020 has been a bit different. But already this year, I've been blown away by the amount of support that we've seen. Thank you to the countless numbers of you who have stepped up and supported Servant Stage during one of our most difficult seasons ever. It's because of you that I'm getting phone calls from folks who are really devastated right now, saying that they watched Around the World in 80 Days and laughed and laughed and laughed, that they sung along with A Million Dreams, songs of inspiration, and felt hope and joy again. You are making that possible. Thank you for your support. Until we can hug again at performances and during visits, I wish you all the very best and the safest spring possible.
Thank you, Nathan, for all of your hard work in putting this family meeting together. Thanks to everybody for watching, for joining us and supporting and being the reason that Servant Stage exists. We love you. We miss you all so very much. We're going to continue doing our very best to keep serving you during this time while we look forward to the future and the joy of being together again. In the meantime, take care, take courage, be well, and we hope that you'll join us again next Friday night, 7 p.m., for the next Living Room Concert. God bless you all. Good night.